people? This is Patrick, and these are my picks for your NRW, giving you the NEW on August 1st, 2018. It's been a wild, crazy past couple of days. Just enjoyed the reunion, BlurredCon 2018. It was a dope time. Got to talk on a few panels, the power of inclusivity with my buddy J-Mark, the Gamer's Guide. Mike Flood and another of J-Mark's pals. Really cool bringing forth that conversation about, you know, representation in comics. You know, I'm all about that. So that was really cool. Shout out to my boy Scoob. I helped film his cooking panel. He is a chef in real life, and he is now trying to incorporate nerddom in cooking and all that. And it was kind of a cool little precursor, because Scoob will be bringing his nerddom in food to our channel. We'll be having a food show on our channel very soon, so look forward to that. And so it was fun to talk about food at the panel, and I gotta give it up to Scoob. He's a very nervous guy in person, and this was kind of his first time really showcasing himself with what he loves, so that was really fun. And always awesome, the BlurredCon cosplay contest. You cosplayers always bring it, and y'all brought it again. Had a good time with judges Alley Cat Cosplay, Spectre Cosplay, and Sammy Bess. And we also had a fun little engagement. So shout out to Tony Bologna and Decatur, aka Luna Bean Cosplay. That was really dope. That was a lot of fun. And love is beautiful. And so thank you for showing love and show to everyone and rejuvenating all of our spirits with that. So that was really cool. And just a good time with my con fam, the squad, everybody. Y'all know who y'all are. A lot of fun. So yeah. Check for all those episodes. I got a ton of interviews. I recently posted up my interview with the Dora Milaje from Black Panther, some of the members of the Dora Milaje, Lakeisha Tucker, Carrie Bernans, and Constance Ejuma. Very sweet gals, and also stunt women as well, beyond just being actors. They did a lot of the cool stuff. Keisha Tucker actually was the one, she was Okoye, Danai Gurira's stunt double, and she was actually the one on top of the car in that cool scene in South Korea. That was really dope, and she's super cool. And small world, she's friends with my boy Samuel J. What up, Jay? So we're gonna have to, you know, bring them on again, you know, since they're part of the fam. So good stuff, but what are you here for? You're here for my picks, and so let me give them to you, people. I'm a big wrestling fan. As a matter of fact, going back to BlurredCon, I decided to cosplay for the cosplay contest. I came out as one of my favorite wrestlers, kind of like an amalgamation of Jimmy and Jay, the Usos. It's not paranoia, it's the Usos. So I came out and I actually had the theme dropping, came out with my entourage, it was badass. So anyway, big wrestling fan. Back in the day, during the Attitude Era, it was a lot of fun. You got The Rock, you got Stone Cold, you had a bunch of crazy, cool wrestlers back at that time. It was really fun. And where's my favorite wrestler who hates the current wrestling stuff? Gianno, can you hear me?
Yeah.
How was the Attitude Era for you, bro? Was that a good time period in wrestling for you?
It was life.
There you go. Gianno, with the backup on that one. So Attitude Era was great, and Boom Studios is showcasing the Attitude Era with WWE Attitude Era 2018 special, collection of stories from that time period. Can't wait to check that out. They've been having a lot of fun and giving us a lot of great material with that imprint that they have with Boom. So just, you know, there was a Sasha Banks one, you know, some of the current wrestlers, but them going back and digging some of the old stuff out of the crates and giving some additional stories to the pay-per-view events that we enjoyed is fun. You know, I dig it. Mankind, I think there's a piece with Mankind in this one. Undertaker, Kane, the Brothers of Destruction, DX. I'm down for it, man. That was a great time in wrestling, so I can't wait to check that out. So that's my first book out the gate. Next book out the gate is a kind of a throwback book. It's from Dynamite Entertainment. They purchased up a lot of the old superhero license that were pre-DC, pre-Marvel. You may not know about them too well, but you should, because they were kind of like the foundation that brought us a lot of those new characters that we know and enjoy. Project Superpowers, number one. Let me tell you a little bit. You know what? I'm going to read from this one real quick, and then to kind of block me from rereading, I'm going to throw these pictures up in front of you so you can see how cool it is. The Project Superpowers heroes came from the past. Now they have to prove their relevance in the modern world. A 21st century threat is coming for us all. What dread secrets does the death-defying devil hold? The lighthouse will rise, and the spirit of the American flag will take on a new host. But will it be enough? Can superheroes still save the day? So yes, Really cool. I don't know. There's just something nostalgic about seeing these characters, and the artwork and the writing are always very solid when they do these. When Dynamite puts out these new heroes, well, these old heroes anew. So I can't wait to check that out. All right. Now for my top pick, I'm not gonna give you too much because I don't know really what's going on. There's a person by the name of Requiem running around in the Marvel Universe, and the Infinity Stones are out and about. You know, I'm still reeling from Avengers Infinity War, people, and they're doing the same thing right now in the current comic book line. I think Wolverine has a stone, but like there's all these other stones, and what's going on? And you know, with Marvel, with their big crossovers, they had to put out a ton of covers. There's a lot of different covers. Here's a, you know, the first one, and I'm actually throwing it. You probably already seen it right now as I'm doing this, because you know that's what we do on here. The regular cover, this one's really cool. There's Requiem, I think, right there on the front. And then there's another one right there that's really cool. Sick. So, yeah, I don't know too much what's going on. All I know is the Infinity Stones are all over the place. We have all of our cast of characters within Marvel, the Avengers, trying to track it down. So, it's going to be a fun ride. I always like when we have this stuff going on. And as you know, with Marvel, Marvel is always doing a crossover. Yes, so this is the crossover of 2018. It's the event of 2018. And if you're not keeping up, then you're out. You know what I'm saying? So anyway, those are my picks. WWE Attitude Era Special number one is one of my picks. Then Project Superpowers number one. And Infinity Wars number one. They're all number ones because you're number one. Thank you for watching. And I'm out of here.
Rolling, rolling.